started painting by mistake, and everybody laughs when I tell them that story, because I actually started during the snowstorm of 2014. I was home bored, and I said, I need to find something to do. I literally heard a voice tell me to get some old wood in the garage and some paint I had left over from some gifts I made for my sister who just crossed in a sorority. And I started doodling on that piece of wood. And I said, this would be dope if I outlined it in black. I wonder what it would look like. And I put my first piece on Instagram and I sold it for like $40. I said, what if I did this like 5 or 6 times and start paying some bills? And I did that. And like a month later, I literally had a collection of about 25 pieces. And I started networking with different people in the art community, getting their ideas and their opinions. And I became an artist almost overnight. I took all of my frustration, all my sadness, all my happiness, all of my energy. I said, I want to give the earth a reason to miss me when I'm gone. So I said, let me find a way to put my signature all over this earth. And what better way to do that is with artwork. So it was my way of enlarging my territory without booking a flight. So I was able to share my art all over the world. I just shipped a piece to Johannesburg, South Africa last week. So that should be there any minute now. I have a piece in Qatar. And of course the Caribbean islands, I mean, I see it all over and I've shipped it all over. So it's just really exciting to take something that was your personal healing and turn it into a real gift and a living. I see myself as being the premier African-American female designer for textiles worldwide. I'm obsessed with African culture. Of course, that's where our original roots came from, but I'm absolutely in love with the use of color and textiles from our culture, and I want to actually study that and go over to Nigeria, some of the other factories, to learn exactly what they're doing with their fabric, what makes it so magical, and bring it to the States and make it accessible to us here. Without even knowing the theme, it seems like I was made for this moment. I just started about 2 or 3 years ago. I know moving art was a quiet, steaming movement around that time as well. And it's like a perfect cross-section, a cross-path of both movements. I'm studying being a king and a queen. And my great-grandmother's name is Queen. So my parents have always called me Queen growing up. And so the fact that we're studying African royalty for this theme is perfect, because I just started painting African royalty on different maternity shoots. So I'm just excited that everything kind of, it's like wow, like I feel like I'm writing a story and then I'm the star character.